What is happening in Israel right now is not God's war. We are hearing churches and we are hearing prophets saying that this is the Ezekiel war and this is also the Daniel war. I think as a church, guys, we need to learn to run to the Bible first before we come to any conclusions. So let us look at those scriptures that are thrown around to say that what is happening right now in Israel is God's war.
I saw myself in the citadel of Susa, in the province of Elam, beside the Ulai Canal. I looked up, and there before me was a ram with two horns, standing beside the canal. I watched the ram as it charged towards the west, and the north, and the south. No animal could stand against it, and none could rescue from its power. It did as it pleased, and became great.
So this war, it does not start inside Israel. By the way, the Daniel 8 war does not start from inside Israel. It started by Iran. The Bible says Iran enrages Turkey, and then they clash. And then after that clash, the Bible says that Turkey is going to be divided into four. And then after that being divided into four, it is only then that one of the four horns from those four divisions that they're going to come into Israel. It did not happen like that. What is happening right now is not what is happening in Daniel chapter 8. And then the second scripture is in Ezekiel. People are saying that this is the Ezekiel war. We have to read scriptures, guys. If you have read Ezekiel, you realize that the Ezekiel war starts in the north. But this one started in the south, Hamas in Gaza. Gaza is in the south of Israel, guys. So the first thing, Jay, the war in Ezekiel starts in the north, and this one started in the south. And the second thing is that the war in Ezekiel, it's a national war. The Bible says nations against Israel. But this one, we all know that Hamas is part of that landmass of Israel, but it's not nations that have come together against Israel. So that is the second red flag. And another point, the Bible says that there is not going to be help. The Bible says that people are going to watch from a distance when Israel is attacked. When you read the Bible, Israel is going to be alone, guys. America needs to know this. American prophets, you need to know this. You are not going to be the helper of Israel. In fact, no one is going to be the helper of Israel in the end time. At the end of the day, Israel is standing alone. So we can't be agitating our church members saying that this is the Ezekiel war, this is the Daniel war. When clearly when you read, you begin to realize that, no man, this goat is going to come northward, the Bible says, of Israel, you know. And the person who's going to come into the landmass of Israel, according to Daniel chapter 8, is going to come coming from the area of Assyria and Turkey, guys. So that is not what is happening today. This war is not a war of God. In fact, this war is a war of the same people who brought COVID to us. You know, the same people who are managing COVID are the same people who are managing this war. And the objective is to collapse the system so that we can move into the system of mystery Babylon. We can move into the system that drives us to the system of the Antichrist. There is an intentional agenda of collapsing the system. So this war is actually a proxy war of the puppet masters who want to collapse the world. That is what is happening. How should a Christian react to the situation in Israel right now? The first thing that we need to do, I think honestly, even if you saw what was happening during the pandemic, is that we don't know our Bibles. The first thing that we should do is to go to scripture. And so that we can get an understanding from scripture of how these things are going to turn out. That is the first thing that we're going to do, we need to do. The second thing is that we need to distance ourselves. I personally believe that we need to distance ourselves from this, because this is not God's war. You know, this is a war that is ran by the puppet masters who want to collapse the world. So we should distance ourselves from it. The least we can do is to pray for people who are perishing there. But us saying that we support Israel, we support this one, we support this one, I think we should abstain from that. The least we can do is to pray. Oh Father, may you protect children, may you protect women, may you protect the innocent, as the puppet masters of the world want to collapse the world. We all know that the Bible says we must pray for the peace of Jerusalem. That is our duty as Christians. We should be praying for the peace of Jerusalem. But should we be panicking? We should not be panicking. Is this the last war? This is not the last war. What is the purpose of this war? The purpose of this war is to collapse the system as it is. And it has nothing to do with God. And it has everything to do with Mystery Babylon moving us into the system of the Antichrist. Stay blessed and continue to push your intimacy with Jesus. That is the best thing you can hear about this whole Israel thing, that you must fix your intimacy with the Holy Ghost. Shalom, shalom, shalom.